Hi guys, and welcome to another Bootstrap 4 video tutorial. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, in our last video we created this sort of swirling logo and Wheel of Fortune thing here. Let's continue with this theme. What if we want to make this navbar change color when somebody mouses over it? I think I'm going to get rid of this here because there's too much going on. So I'm going to open my brackets software and just delete that section. This brackets is a free text editor and you can download it from a link below this video. Okay, so let's just get rid of the Wheel of Fortune and that young lady there. That's that. Delete, Control S to save. Back to the site. Do a refresh. There we go. That's a little easier to watch now. It's not quite as hypnotizing. Okay, so at the moment we've just got a white nav bar there, which is fine, nice clean looking. But perhaps when people go up to these icons here, we could have it change color. Very easy to do. If we go back to our brackets at the moment, if we go up, I've got some on-page CSS here rather than an external CSS style sheet. And if we look down here, here's our navbar. At the moment, it's white. If you're not sure, you can go back to the site. Hit. I'm using Google Chrome here because it's got the great inspector tools. Hit F12 or just right click and hit inspect. And there's the navbar right there. And you can see the background color's white. So when we hover over it, we want to change it to a different color. I haven't really got anything in mind, so let's, for argument's sake, just say green. So what I'm going to do is copy this background dark that's telling it to be white, Control C to copy, drop down one and paste it in there. What I'm going to do is, after the dark, I'm going to put a full colon, no space. This is really important. Do not put a space in there, and the word hover, H-O-V-E-R. Now, this is going to tell it that when we hover our mouse over the background, or that nav bar, background dark, it's going to do something. Let's get rid of that gap there and there. Let's change that color. I'll just say, like I say, green. For sake of argument, Control S to save. Back to the site, do a refresh. You won't see any difference at the moment, but now when I hover over it or go to one of those links, that background should change to green. There we go. Very easy. But it's kind of happening a little too instantly. I'd like to see it fade in, perhaps take a second or half a second or something to actually fade in, so it's not quite as simple as that. So if we go back to our brackets here, and not on the hover element, we want to do it on the actual main element here. I'm going to put in transition. And let's say for about a second, so I'm going to say all, just in case I want to do some more. I'm going to say 1 second. And let's try ease in, ease out, or ease in, out, I should say. Ease in, out. That'll sort of make it ease in and then back out again. And a colon on the end of that. So let's just save that. Control S. Back to the site. Quick refresh again. Now when we do it, that's better. It's taking a second to fade in, and it's taking a second to fade out. I think that looks a lot better than doing it sort of instantly. You know, now when somebody goes up to one of these links, it's going to change that color there. So there you have it. That was very easy to do. But what I'm going to do, for compatibility reasons, this, some of these effects certainly won't work on older versions of Windows Explorer, which is pretty much obsolescent now. They're no longer upkeeping it. But to make sure it's compatible with all browsers like Opera, Mozilla Firefox, we want to add some vendor prefixes. So let's go back to our brackets. And we've actually done that up here a little bit. I'll show you the full range. WebKit will probably do it. So let's just copy WebKit and drop down one after our transition here, again on the main element, not on the hover element. And we'll copy that. And we'll do another one. Drop down one. This time we'll say dash Moz for Mozilla Firefox, or Mozilla Firefox, however you like to say it. And let's do one more. It's another browser. I don't actually use this, but I've heard some pretty good reports about it. Opera. I don't know if you use it. But if you do all that, that will make it compatible with all these other browsers here. And do a quick save. You won't see any difference on the actual site there. Do a refresh. But if you were to open it in one of these browsers, it should work. So there you have it. There is how to change your navbar color on hover with Bootstrap 4. Very easy, nice little effect. So I hope you've enjoyed that. If you have, please like, subscribe, and share the video. If you're interested in web design, take one of our web design courses below. We've got some great free courses and also some paid courses. We've got some huge discounts for our YouTube subscribers, so do take a look. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.